After a disappointing week which led to one of the most lopsided results in international team match play history, the Australian contingent had to wait until Sunday for some highlights at the 12th President's Cup. A strong American side dominated the contest for much of the week, but the Sunday single saw both Adam Scott and Jason Day register their first points, while Mark Leishman ground out a hard-fought half-point. With the result all but decided by Saturday night, there was little left to play for, but pride come the final day and the Australians delivered. Mark Leishman, who played well for most of the week for little reward, was given the responsibility of leading out the singles matches as the internationals desperately tried to conjure up a miracle. They needed to win all 12 matches Sunday, and while that was unlikely, captain Nick Price was looking to get as much blue on the board early in the day as possible. Playing against fired-up rookie Kevin Chappell, Leishman was in trouble early to fall 2 down through 2 holes, but had cut the deficit to 1 by the turn. A win at 10 saw the pair all square, then Leishman snuck ahead with a win at the 13th. Chappell responded to square the match at 15, Leishman went ahead again at 16, but was immediately reeled back in by Chappell at 17, leaving all to play for at the tough par 3/18. Chappell hit first and applied the pressure with a majestic iron, but Leishman responded with one even better, and when both players made par, the U.S. had the half point they needed to ensure a tie at worst. In the match behind Leishman, it was Jason Day against Charlie Hoffman, and after a week of lackluster golf, the 2015 PGA champion finally found form. He went ahead at the first, but with back-to-back losses at 8 and 9 found himself one down at the turn. A brilliant birdie at the short 10th squared things again, and he was never worse than one up from there to the clubhouse, the eventual margin 32. Adam Scott faced perhaps the toughest match of the three Australian Sunday as he went head-to-head with reigning U.S. Open champion Brooks Koepka. The long-hitting American had been impressive most of the week, while Scott had lost all three of his previous matches. Scott found something on Sunday, and after holing an impressive putt for birdie and a half at the first, found himself in a dogfight the rest of the day. Just 5 of the 16 holes played were halved, Koepka taking 4 and Scott 7 in a 32 result that was the only bright spot for Scott all week. The international team will get their chance to make amends when the President's Cup returns to Royal Melbourne in 2019.